Good morning, student. So in the last lecture, we understand the operation of three-phase control rectifier with the assumption that the source inductance is negligible, and firing angle for this thyristor is, or firing angle for this valve is a zero. So based on that, we first draw the waveform for alpha zero without any ignition angle delay. So as we know that when there is a phase crossover point between two phases, from this point that phase valve come into conduction because here alpha is zero. So this is the waveform for alpha zero with the assumption that source inductance is zero, and we get this line to line voltage is at every 60 degree intervals. Then we analyze this operation of this converter with the consideration of firing angle delay, but assumption of source inductance negligible is remains same. So here you can see that after this phase crossover point between C and A phase, I provide the firing angle delay alpha to the valve number 1, which is connected with the phase A or EA phase. So after this phase crossover point at alpha, the valve 1 will start conducting. You can see that in this waveform. Same way, valve number 3 will start from 0 to alpha. It means after alpha, your valve number 3 will start here with the delay angle alpha. Phase crossover is at the 0 degree. So here at alpha, from this 0 degree, it will start conduction. Same way, the rest of the valves will conduct at alpha degree, but with the assumption that the source inductance is negligible. Clear? And then after we derive the average output voltage equations for both the cases, alpha 0 and with alpha. Clear? Now, as you saw that in this waveform, as we increase the alpha, there is a phase angle displacement between the voltage, phase voltage, and this phase current or supply currents. So what is the phase displacement relation? So that is depend upon the firing angle alpha. So now let's understand this operation by the waveform. This is omega t. Suppose this is a phase A. Now, let's draw the waveform of phase A current. Suppose that this is a phase A current. Means it is IA. So as we know that phase A, that is connected with the valve number 1 in the upper group and valve number 4 from the lower group. It means this positive current in phase A, that is because of conduction of valve number 1. So this current is because of valve 1 conducting. As you see in this figure, the valve of phase A, EA, that is connected with the anode of valve number 1, and the same phase which is connected with the cathode of valve number 4. So phase A current, that is a combination of current of valve 1 plus valve 4. So as we already discussed in the last lecture, that IA, that is nothing but I1 minus I4. Clear? Because the valve current flowing from this valve 4, that is negative, so it is I1 minus I4. So that same current here I am drawing here. Here this IA, this one, it is nothing but a combination of valve 1 and valve 4. So in the positive half cycle of voltage, the current is positive. It means that valve 1 is conducting. So this rectangular current with the magnitude ID is a direct current, which is because of conduction of valve number 1. Clear? So this current is flowing from the supply when valve 1 is conducting. Clear? So this is the AC current. Same way, in the negative cycle, when voltage is negative, at this point of time, this current is negative. Clear? So this current is because of conduction of valve number 4 conducting. Valve number 4 is conducting at this time. So the combination of this I1, this is called I1, this is called I4. So this combination of I1 and I4, that is nothing but your current IA. So this is the current of IA. This whole current is nothing but IA. I called as IA. Clear? But as we know that the supply current, ideally it is a sinusoidal. Clear? But here it is a rectangular waveform because that contains some harmonics. So if we draw the fundamental current of this current IA, so it is look like this way. It is in same phase with the voltage because at the DC side only resistance is present. So we call this as a fundamental component of IA. So I call this a IA1. IA1, that is a fundamental current phasor. All these are the phasor quantities. And IA, that is nothing but phase A line current. Phase A line current. Same way EA, this EA voltage, that is a voltage of phase A line to neutral voltage. Line to neutral voltage. Clear? So here you can see that there is no firing angle delay provided to this valve number 1. So it is starting from phase crossover point. So what is the angle at phase crossover point when valve 1 is conducting? So as you saw in the waveform, at this phase crossover point between C and A phase, from this point your valve 1 will start conducting without alpha, or alpha is equal to 0 degree. At this point alpha 0, so from this point to this point your valve 1 will start conducting, or EA phase come into picture at the output side. Clear? So this angle is minus 120 degree. Clear? So from this minus 120 degree to this 0 degree, this valve 1 is conducting and gives a positive current. So in this duration, you get this rectangular wave shape because of conduction of valve number 1. Same way here, when EA phase is negative, so when the EA phase is negative here, after this phase crossover point, you can see that at 60 degree here, plus 60 degree, here where phase A become most negative as compared to other phases, between the 60 degree to 180 degree here. Clear? So during this period between 60 to 180, you get the negative current of phase A from the supply side. So that current is because of conduction of valve number 4, which is the lower group valve, which is connected with the phase A or EA voltages. Clear? So from the negative group, the valve 4 is conducting, so that gives the phase A current. So combination of this current positive and this current, that gives the total supply currents. Clear? So now write down this angle of this current starting from minus 120 to 0 degree, then it gives a positive current. So here from this angle where the current is positive, it is minus 120 degree. And here when it gives a 0, so it is 0 degree. You can see here from minus 120, from here to here, you get the current. So here this angle is 0 degree, and in between that, the angle is minus 60 degree, exactly half duration. So it is minus 60 degree. So this is a current flowing into the phase or valve number 1. Clear? Same way here, this angle is 60 degree, and this angle is 180 degree. So during this period, wall number 4 is conducting and they give the negative current. So combination of this I1 and I4, that is nothing but your IA phase, which is I1 minus I4. Clear? This one. And this wave shape is without any firing angle delay. Clear? This wave shape is for alpha 0 degree. Clear? So with alpha 0, what is the phase relationship between voltage and current? Suppose EA is the voltage phasor. And your fundamental component of this current is IA1. So without firing angle delay, both IA1 and EA phasor, both are in the same phase. Clear? For alpha 0 degree. Now we draw the waveform. When you increase the alpha, what is the phase relationship between this EA and IA1? So when you calculate the alpha from this phase crossover point is at minus 120 degree. You can see here in this waveform, this phase crossover point is at minus 120 degree. So you calculate the alpha for wall number 1 from this minus 120 degree. Same way here, from this phase crossover point, B phase become most positive and wall number 3 is connected from the upper group. So from this crossover point, you calculate the alpha for wall number 3. Same way, from this point, phase C become most positive and wall number 5 is connected with that phase. So wall number 5, firing angle you calculate from this phase crossover point, 120 degree. Clear? Here we talk about the phase A. So which is connected with wall number 1 in the upper group. So from this minus 120 degree, we calculate the alpha for with wall number 1. So from this minus 120 degree, if I apply the alpha is equal to 30 degree and then draw this waveform of EA phase and this IA phase current. So what is the phase relationship between these two quantity? Let's draw this waveform. This is omega t. I draw the same voltage, phase voltage, or say the line to neutral voltage. So for this is a minus 120 degree here. But from this point you calculate alpha. Suppose that my alpha is 30 degree. So from minus 120 plus 30 degree here, at this point I fire the wall number 1. So obviously the phase A current is start from here. Clear? And which is ended at the after 120 degree. Clear? So suppose this is a minus 120 plus 30 is minus 90 degree. So minus 90 degree to 30 degree, it will remain in conduction. Clear? So suppose that this is a 30 degree here. So it is conducting up to this point here. So this is a phase current with alpha 30 degree, starting from here and ending here. Each wall is conducting for 120 degree duration, even if changing the alpha. So this alpha 30 degree, this is a value of IA phase, this is a value of EA phase. Clear? So what is the phase relationship between this voltage and current? Now it is not in the same phase because you apply the firing angle delay alpha 30 degree, your phase current IA, which is phase shifted by 30 degree with respect to this EA. Clear? So here we draw the phasor diagram for this phase EA, phasor wave, phasor EA, voltage phasor EA, and the fundamental component of this current, which is a sine wave. It is look like this way, sine wave. So the fundamental component IA1 and EA. Now phase relationship between these two quantities 30 degree lag behind the voltage EA. IA1, it means fundamental component of this current, is 30 degree lag behind this voltage phasor EA because you provide the firing angle delay alpha 30 degree. Clear? Now same way, suppose you provide the alpha is equal to 90 degree, draw the waveform. Now from this point you calculate alpha. Now alpha 90 is where? Here it is. Here if you calculate alpha from this point, it is at here, and you get the current up to this point. Now for this case, the phase relationship between phasor EA and IA1, that is 90 degree, because you provide the alpha 90 degree. Clear? This is IA, its fundamental component is IA1. This is EA voltage, its phasor is EA. So phase relationship between EA and IA1 is 90 degree. It means that the phase displacement between the voltage and current is depend upon the delay angle. As you increase the delay angle, phase relationship between voltage and current is. So let's derive the equation of the peak value of fundamental frequency component of alternating line current. Alternating line current. So for that, suppose I draw the waveform. Of the alternating current. It is a square wave. Because it contains some harmonic, because of the switching of the valve, the supply side harmonics are injected. So your supply current becomes this rectangular wave shape. And the wave magnitude of this value is ID, which is a current at the DC side. Clear? Same way it is a minus ID. Clear? Suppose that it starts from minus pi by 3 and it pi by 3. Because we know that each valve is conduct for 120 degree duration. So this duration is, this duration is 120 degree or 2 pi by 3. And this angle is pi by 2. This angle is minus pi by 2. Clear? So now let's calculate the peak value of fundamental frequency component of the alternating current. I give the name ILM. Here I calculate the peak value for the period of only half period, half cycle. So here half cycle period is pi by 2. So I take the base of pi by 2 and take the integration from here, where I get the output current positive. So it, this starting period is minus pi by 3 and ending period is this pi by 3. So minus pi by 3 to pi by 3, I take the integration of this ID, which is a function of cosine. So it is ID cos x into dx. Here I replace this omega t by the x. Clear? So by taking the integration of this, this 1 upon pi by 2, it becomes 2 by pi. ID is constant. Integration of cos, that is sine x from minus pi by 3 to pi by 3. So some simplification of this equation, 2 by pi into ID, which is constant, then sine x is replaced by pi by 3, minus x is replaced by minus pi by 3. So it is minus sine minus pi by 3. So it is 2 by pi into ID sine pi by 3, that is nothing but sine 60, minus minus plus, again sine 60. So it is 2 sine 60. So sine 60, we know that root 3 by 2. So it is 2 into ID divided by pi. It is 2 sin 60. So 2 into sin 60 is root 3 by 2. So 2 cancel out. So finally the equation is 2 into root 3 divided by pi into ID. Or numerical you can write as 1.11 times ID. ID is the direct current at the DC side. So this is the expression of peak value of the fundamental frequency component. Now what is the RMS value? So let's derive the RMS value of this fundamental frequency component. I give the name, it is IL1, fundamental frequency component of AC line current. So the value of this IL1, this is a fundamental frequency component, and we derive here this is a peak value of the fundamental component. So the relationship between RMS value of fundamental component, sorry, this is RMS value of fundamental component, which is peak divided by root 2. So peak value is ILM divided by root 2, that gives the RMS value of fundamental component. So what is the value of ILM that we derive? 2 into root 3 divided by pi into ID. So right here, 2 into root 3 divided by pi into ID, that is the value of ILM divided by this root 2. So if I write this 2 as a multiplication of root 2 into root 2, so that becomes 2 multiply with the root 3 into ID divided by this pi into root 2. So this root 2 root 2 cancel out. So finally the expression becomes this root 2 multiply root 3, so becomes root 6 divided by pi into ID. Clear? Here I replace this 2 by root 2 into root 2 multiply root 3, this one into ID divided by this pi into this root 2. So this root 2 root 2 cancel out. So root 2 multiply root 3 becomes root 6 divided by pi into ID. So this is the expression of RMS fundamental frequency component of AC line current. Numerical you can write this one as 0.78 into ID. Now let's analyze the operation of this converter with the assumption that the losses in the converter losses is equal to zero. So with this ideal operation, what will happen? The AC power to converter is equal to DC output power of converters, because losses are zero. So with this assumption, what will happen? We provide the three-phase power. We provide the three-phase power to this converter. So equation of three-phase power is 3 into ELN, this is a line to neutral voltage, IL1, fundamental frequency component of the current, into cos phi. So cos phi is what? Nothing but power factor angle between this voltage and current, is equal to DC output power. So DC voltage is VD, average DC voltage, and average DC current is ID. So now with this expression, with the assumption that losses in the converter is zero, now we derive the relationship between your firing angle alpha and this power factor angle. So what is the value of this IL1 in this equation of three phase supply power, which already derived, it is root 6 by pi into ID. What is the value of this VD that we already derived? VD is equal to VD0 cos alpha. In the last lecture, lecture number 17, we derived this equation of average direct voltage with alpha, with the condition is that source inductance is negligible. So in this case, if you put this value of IL1, this value in this equation, so it is root 6 divided by pi into ID into same cos phi is equal to this VD. We replace this VD by this VD0 cos alpha into this ID. We already derived the equation of this VD0 in the last lecture. VD0 is equal to 3 times root 6, 3 into root 6 divided by pi into ELA in terms of line to neutral voltage. We derived this equation in the previous lecture. VD0 is nothing but an average direct voltage with alpha 0. Clear? This is the ideal voltage. So put this value of VD0, 3 root 6 by pi ELA in this equation. So now finally this equation is becomes 3 ELN, write down here, 3 ELN root 6 by pi into ID into cos phi is equal to, replace this VD0 by 3 root 6 by pi line to neutral voltage into ID into cos alpha. Yes. Simple here, I replace this VD0 in this equation, VD0 by this 3 root 6 by pi ln into cos alpha into ID. Yes. So here you can see that this root 6 by pi, root 6 by pi cancel out, 3 cancel out, ELN is ELN cancel out, ID, ID cancel out. So the remaining part is that cos phi is equal to cos alpha. So what is the meaning of this expression? Cos phi is equal to cos alpha. It means that your power factor angle at the supply side or power factor of the supply, that is depend upon the fiery angle delay alpha. So what will happen with this assumption that the converter losses are zero? Clear? This expression we get with the assumption that losses in the converter is zero or negligible. Yeah, both are same. So with this assumption we get the expression cos phi is equal to cos alpha. So what is the effect of this expression on the active and reactive power flowing from the supply side? So as the ignition angle delay or fiery angle delay shifts the current wave, its fundamental component is also shifted by angle theta is equal to alpha. Clear? It means that with alpha 0, the fundamental component of current, it means IA1, is in phase with, phase voltage EA for alpha 0. Clear? So at this time, what is active power? PA is equal to, as you know the equation, EA into IA1 cos phi. So IA1 is in phase with the EA and here alpha is 0, and as we know that with this assumption your phi is equal to alpha. Clear? So alpha 0, it means phi is also 0. So it is EA into IA1 cos 0, and we know that cos 0 is 1, so that gives a maximum value, which is EA into IA1. So your active power for alpha 0, which is maximum, and its value is EA into IA1. But what is the reactive power? Reactive power equation is that EA into IA1 into sine phi, it is a sine function. So now with the same alpha 0, it means your phi is also 0. So with this, reactive power equation is EA into IA1 into sine 0, and we know the sine 0 is 0, so your reactive power is 0. It means that at alpha 0, your active power is maximum and reactive power is 0. And as the alpha is increases from 0 to 90 degree, 0 to 90 degree, what will happen? Your active power is reduces, and at 90 degree what will happen? They become cos 90, so it becomes 0. So your active power becomes 0, and at 90 degree sin 90 becomes 1, means your reactive power becomes maximum. So as you move from 0 to 90 degree, your active power is positive, but it is decreases from 0 to 90. And same way, your reactive power that is increasing from 0 to 90. So the same way, as we move from, as a alpha from 90 to 180 degree, active power PA becomes negative and increases the magnitude. Becomes negative and its magnitude is increasing in negative direction. At this time, reactive power QA that is remains positive but decreases in magnitude. Same way, at alpha is equal to 180 degree, the active power PA that is negative maximum and reactive power is becomes 0. Okay. So as we see this relationship between active power and reactive power in terms of waveform, so for that, let's draw the waveform of active and reactive power. This is a sine function, so this is a reactive power EAIA1 into sine phi. Now, let's draw the waveform of active power. It is a cosine function, so it is 90 degree phase shifted by this reactive component of the current. So here omega t is equal to 0, this is 90 degree, this is 180, this is 270 degree, and this is a 360 degree. So you can see that this active component, which is PA, equation is EAIA1 cos phi. You can see that at omega t is equal to 90 degree or phi is equal to 90 degree, your reactive power is maximum, but at this time active power is 0 because phi is 90 degree, so cos 90 is 0. So as we move from 0 to 90 degree, what will happen? The reactive power is increasing, but the active power is decreases. But it is still positive. Same way, from 90 to 180, you can see that reactive power is positive, but it is decreasing. But the active power becomes negative and its magnitude is increases. Okay? Up to this 180. At 180 degree, here you can see that the active power PA that becomes maximum, or you can say the negative maximum. At this time, the value of this reactive power is 0. Yeah. So this is a relationship between the active and reactive power from the supply side of the converter, with the assumption that cos alpha is equal to cos phi. And when this is possible, and this is possible when losses of the converters are neglected. So I hope you understand this case, what will happen when the losses of the converter are neglected, what is the relationship between the phasor of active power and reactive power, or relationship between the active power supply from the converter and reactive power supply from the converter.